guys, it's Aoife from Words of Clover and I'm here with the third edition of my book match series. So if you haven't watched one of my previous videos in the series, this is basically a video where I match up a booktuber with a book that I think they will really enjoy. I really love doing these videos, they're so much fun. I also wanted to shout out Victoria from What Victoria Read, who recently did her own version of this video, and I really enjoyed that too, and she also recommended me a book, which was so much fun, and I definitely cannot wait to get my hands on that book soon so I can read it. I will leave her video linked down below if you guys want to check out. If you like this style of video, you can check out her video. So the first booktuber in this video that I want to recommend a book is actually someone who I'm really scared to recommend a book to, because she will either hate this book or love this book, and I'm not really sure exactly which one it will be, but there's a lot of things with this book that I think are kind of her buzzwords, and I think there could be the potential there that she might really, really enjoy it. And that is Kayla, who is obviously a very big booktuber, and yeah, it's very scary to kind of recommend a book to someone who is a big booktuber, but I'm really hoping that she will enjoy this book. And the book I want to recommend to Kayla is After the Silence by Louise O'Neill. This is Louise O'Neill's kind of first foray into like the thriller slash mystery, and I think Kayla has maybe read one Louise O'Neill book before, and she's a couple of others on her TBR. I think she does have this one on her TBR, I'm not 100% sure. But she definitely hasn't read it anyway. And this is basically about this island off the coast of Ireland called Inishroon. And it is based around a murder that happened 10 years previously to this girl called Nessa Crowley, who was found dead in this garden. And 10 years later, we are following Keane and Kinslaw as a documentary crew has come to Inishroon to kind of basically interview the inhabitants of Inishroon and interview the families of those involved in this murder mystery, in the style of a lot of kind of true crime documentaries that we have seen become really popular lately, particularly the Cork Murder podcast, which Louise O'Neill got a lot of inspiration for this book. Mostly follow Keelan Kinslaw in this book, who is our main character and who is directly involved in this kind of mystery, and her family, her husband was like the chief suspect for this girl's murder. Her point of view is just so interesting because there's just so many different things going on in Keelan's mind, a lot of things to kind of untwist with Keelan, and we're kind of trying to figure out what is she hiding. Is she protecting someone? Who is she protecting? Why is she protecting them? Or indeed, could she have been the main culprit all along? We don't really know. It's sneaky and suspicious about her, but at the same time, she is someone who is quite vulnerable and fragile and someone you want to look after. From watching Kayla's videos, she really loves things that are set in small towns. She loves things that are insular, and she does love a good mystery or thriller book. And obviously, this is set in an island, so it is a very small town. It's insular. We're following this very small community who have a lot of opinions around different people, particularly blow-ins, like the Kinslaws who come in, who aren't particularly part of the island for years. This book also has a really great examination into emotional and abusive manipulative relationships. I feel it's quite well done, and there is a dive into that. Not only kind of people who are trapped in those relationships, but sometimes people who almost in a way willingly trap themselves in or become so deep that they can't find a way out and they don't know if they want a way out. And this book as well, it's not really a whole like thriller. I wouldn't say it's a real thriller. It's more of a mystery, and it's more about the why than the who. I think it's more about the whys than the whos in this book, and it's more about a character study than a lot of action. O'Neill also is kind of well known for never wrapping her books in neat little bows. She always kind of gives open endings, and I know that Kayla doesn't mind this because she really loves Wilder Girls by Rory Power, which has a very, very divisive open ending. Some people love it, some people hate it. And I wouldn't say like it's completely like that, but again, it doesn't wrap everything up in a neat little bow. Who knows? Maybe Kayla will love it, maybe she'll hate it. If she ever reads it, it'll be really interesting to know. Another booktuber I want to recommend a book to is Aoife over at Pretty Purple Polka Dots. I really enjoy Aoife's videos, not just because she has a brilliant name, obviously, but she does read lots of really nice contemporary books we would love to dip into now and again. Also buddy reading a book soon next week called The Vanishing Half, and I'm really looking forward to reading that with her. But as I said, as Aoife really enjoys contemporary books, I wanted to recommend a really cute contemporary book that I really enjoyed a few years ago called Winter at the Dog and Duck. In this book, we are following a character called Ellie, who basically has returned to her childhood village after quitting her job in London that was really high stress and just not really good for her, and she decided to pack it all in and move back home. She's basically trying to figure out what she wants to do next. She has taken shifts in her local pub called The Dog and Duck, and she's also doing kind of a doggy daycare dog walking business as well. She also has an ex who's kind of sniffing around her again and is kind of talking to her about getting back together, and she doesn't really know if she wants to be involved with that at all, while at the same time a new man has moved into the village and she's starting to get to know him as well. This is just really cute, set in this little village, it's kind of cozy, it's nice kind of community spirit as well. The dog and duck is obviously the central point in this book as well, where a lot of people come together, and there's a danger in this book as well of it being sold. There's also a second book in the series called Summer of the Dog and Duck, so you have like a wintry book and a summery book. book in the series with the same characters. This book, it was just so much fun and really sweet and just a lovely read, and I think Aoife will really like it as well. And then I'm going to go to another Irish booktuber, who is Em over at Perfect Paperback. She's only been doing videos kind of properly again, I think, from the start of lockdown, but she has been doing so well. Like, she, I think, has got over 1,000 subscribers now, and she just does the most loveliest vlogs, and she's just the sweetest person ever. She's so cute, and I really enjoy watching her vlogs. She's just, as I said, a really, really sweet person. And I know Em really enjoys a really nice World War II fiction or historical fiction, particularly World War II, I think. So I wanted to try and think about a really good World War II fiction that she might enjoy. So for this, I've gone with The Sisters of St. Croix by Dania Costello. This is a book, as I said, that is set in World War II, and we are basically following a story during the Nazi occupation of France. We start the story off with a girl called Adelaide, who basically finds out at the start of the book a lot of the family secrets. Because of this, she ends up travelling to France to this convent where her, I think it's her aunt or her great aunt lives, because she wants to find out more about her family. But while she is there, I believe the Nazi occupation ends up happening, and she kind of ends up being stuck there and stuck with the nuns. The nuns basically start helping Jewish orphans who are obviously at risk of being transported to camps by the Nazi soldiers or indeed killed. The nuns take it upon themselves to try and help these families and help these children, and Adelaide gets involved with that. And this is basically one of these World War II stories that mainly focuses on this, like, almost at home fight and this at home struggle and the bravery of ordinary people and ordinary citizens to just do what is good and do what is right. But I really, really enjoyed this read. I think it's just a really great World War II read. I really love reading particularly stories around Nazi occupied France. I always find them really interesting because I think there was just so much pain and suffering to deal with that, with the people who were at home, with the women who were left in villages kind of on their own, and they had to deal with all of this. And I always love reading books around this time. I really enjoyed this book, and I really hope Em will enjoy this book as well. I also wanted to recommend a book to Cody over at Cody's Book Corner. I've been following Cody for quite a while. I'm sure most people know her now because she really did explode in popularity, which was so great to see. And she does this really great kind of Wheel of TBR game that she does every month that is just so much fun to watch. I follow Cody, I think, way back when there was like the small booktuber army thing going on. I think around the time when monetization stopped for small creators. And that is how I originally found Cody. I think she found me first, and we started kind of watching each other's videos back then. And it's just been such a joy to be able to watch her grow and watch her confidence in herself and in her videos grow as well. But Cody really loves a good fantasy novel, and one of my favorite fantasy novels is The Copper Promise by Jen Williams, which is a book set around this kind of quest slash job these three kind of mercenaries take upon themselves. Basically take this job to explore this citadel underneath this city, and I think there is like rumors of riches and treasure and stuff that's there, but also this great evil and this great power that needs to be overcome. And these three end up coming together, and they're kind of very much opposites. There's Wydryn, who is a female warrior. There is Lord Frith, who is this, like, he's not really a warrior, but he is kind of pale and fragile, but he's quite clever and he knows his stuff. And then there is Sebastian, who is this warrior, and he's a little bit of like a himbo. I really enjoy Sebastian. He's very one of these kind of people who's very like, looks really tough but is really soft underneath. And he's someone that you would expect to find in a book like Kings of the Wild. He's very much similar to those characters that are in that. But basically the three go into the citadel and go on this adventure to try and figure out what is in this citadel, and they may or may not awaken this god in the shape of a dragon who threatens destruction of the world, basically. This is a trilogy. The whole trilogy is really good. The first book in particular is excellent. There's a couple of novellas that are also really good. And let's just say that later on in the trilogy, there ends up being this kind of like half human, half dragon warriors that are really, really cool. And they're all female. And they're just awesome. I think this might be one that Cody will really enjoy. Then the last person I wanted to recommend book to is my lovely Emma over at Emma Gillers. I love Emma. We've been following each other's videos for a really long time, and she is just the sweetest, loveliest person. She's just amazing, and yeah, I love her to pieces. I really liked trying to find a book that I could recommend to Emma. I actually had a few different options. I decided to go with Born Wicked by Jessica Spotswood, which is kind of a YA historical fantasy book that I think is right up Emma's street. I think it is kind of short enough and gripping enough that she'll be able to get into it. I know Emma has her hands full right now. She is, I think, studying in college, and she's also trying to write a book, and she also has two small children. She is literally a superwoman, and I think she needs something that is short and easy to read. It's really gripping to get into, and one that she can just like be really immersed in and fly through possibly in a few evenings if she gets the time. This one is perfect for it. This is, as I said, YA, and it is kind of like historical fantasy, almost alternate history in a way, because it's basically as if it's very similar to our world if magic was real. Following these sisters called the Cahill sisters, or the Cahill as a lot of Americans booktubers say. They say Cahill, but I think in Ireland we say Cahill, so I don't really know what the correct one is. I would say ours. But we are following Kate, who is basically trying to keep a really big secret, which is that she and her sisters are all witches. But if they are found out by this kind of ruling organization called the Brotherhood, they are in danger of being put away either in prison or an asylum. So she basically has put it upon herself that she's trying to protect herself, but she's also trying to protect her younger sisters from being found out. And her younger sisters, particularly her middle sister, are a little bit wild and a little bit erratic with their magic, so it's a tough job. The first book is basically Kate trying to make sure that her sisters aren't found out, and we're finding out more about their magic, more about the history of this world, what the world is like, and also kind of this relationship that Kate has kind of blossoming on the horizon, but one that she might have to forfeit for the sake of her sisters. I absolutely love this trilogy. I love this book in particular, but I love the whole trilogy. I love how it explores different relationships. I particularly love the fact that there's a little bit of a love triangle in this book, but it is snuffed out at the end of this book, and then for the rest of the series we have one love interest for Kate, and he is just the sweetest, loveliest person ever. He is just he's a real kind of bookishy boyfriend, the cutest. I really, really love the love interest in this book, love the magic as well, and I love later on in the trilogy when they kind of go and learn more about their magic and learn how to wield their magic better. But I think this is one that Emma might really, really enjoy, so I'm going to recommend this book to her. So that is it for this round of Bookmatch. I'd love to do more of these kind of recommendation videos next year. I would love to try and maybe do one every quarter, at least two or three anyway. If you would like to be Bookmatched, please let me know below. I would love to know more and more booktubers to be able to try Bookmatch, because I do have a really fun time doing this. It is just really fun to do, and I always get so excited when I have a video up and ready to be put up, because I love to see people's reactions. Please leave me all your thoughts and comments down below, as I would love to chat. And thank you guys so much for watching as always, and I'll see you guys again next time.